नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 10 चैप्टर नंबर 2 वर्स नंबर 27। सो दीज आर प्रेयर्स ऑफ द देवास हेडेड बाय ब्रह्मा टू कृष्णा हु इज स्टिल इन द वूम ऑफ देवकी एंड इन द फर्स्ट verse they prayed to him that they take shelter of him and they described his characteristics as satya satyavratam satya parantur satyam satyasya yoni nihitam
satya. I'd like to ask something this verse again.
Yes.
I was just thinking about so many of his pastimes, which is a clash in my mind, so I just want to clarify. Mm. In the sense, the Vaman lives pastime.
Mm.
The Vaman lives pastime.
Mm.
I was just thinking about it. Where else has he, you know, not spoken the truth, and I can get a clarity on this.
Yes.
So in Vaman lives pastime, his feet are shown small,
mm.
and then he expands it. So what I thought in my mind is deceit is also a satyam. Here he's been deceitful, so I just want to clarify for a few points.
So what is the deceit? He said that he wants 3 feet of land by his feet.
Yeah, but then when he showed it to Bali Maharaj, it was small. So that is,
and that is Bali's problem.
But that's a cheat, no, Babaji.
No, he is unlimited.
I
mean, just like Krishna is also unlimited, Yashoda is trying to bind him. So then you will say, well, this is cheating. If he is unlimited, he should show himself as unlimited.
And then what happens in Bhima and Duryodhana's fight?
What happened?
I mean, there also he prompted to Bhima to hit the lower waist, you know, when he's not allowed in the fight.
So what is untruth about that? Did he say that he will not tell Bhima not to hit?
But that's a cheat again.
What is the cheating? He is the upholder of truth. Satyavratam, right? So what is the truth? Truth is that Duryodhana has taken the kingdom. Right? And he's refused to give, although he said that he will return when they come back. So who is cheating?
Yeah, Duryodhana cheated. I'm not denying that.
So then?
He cheated too, right?
How is he cheating? He's just making the things right. Cheating is that I take something from you. If you have cheated me for money, and then I try to get it back from you, then am I cheating you or I'm trying to get my money back from you? Why is that I have to be saintly when you are a cheater, so you go on cheating me? But if I purposefully cheat you, then you can say I am a deceiver. But if you borrowed money from me, and then you said you will give me back after 6 months, you don't give me after that, and you say, no, I never borrowed. So then if I trick you and get my money back, then why is that cheating?
And what about Yudhishthira Maharaj? He told him to speak a lie. When he was truthful,
Yudhishthira
didn't want to do it.
Yeah, that's why I'm saying you are only seeing every incident.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm saying that these people, why is Dronacharya fighting from Duryodhana's side? He is guru from both sides, right?
Yeah.
So why is he fighting from his side? If he is truthful, if Dronacharya is truthful, he should side with the Pandavas, right?
Yeah.
So who is wrong? It is the
then
same thing.
They did it because he was under Dhritarashtra's money and his kingdom.
So that is his mistake. Why he has to be under his money? He is the guru. You think he will starve to death or not?
But then what about him telling Yudhishthira to lie?
That's why I'm saying you are only seeing that particular statement. It's the same thing. If you understand that you cheated me for money and then I cheat you to get my money back, am I cheater or you are cheater? I'm not a cheater, I'm just getting my right back. Now if somebody, he is assisting you in the cheating, right? So I also get even with him. So this is what Dronacharya is doing. If Krishna is cheating somebody and taking their right, is denying their rightful property or rightful possession or whatever, then you can say he is a cheater. But he is trying to establish what is right. And in that process there are people who do not follow dharma. So this is what we have to understand. Vrajanti te mood dhiya parabhavam yenu bhavanti mayavi mayavine. Those who are mayavi, those who are deceptive, if you don't behave deceptively with them, then you are a fool and you will be defeated. Vrajanti te mudadhiya parabhavam. Parabhavam means defeat. Mudadhiya means foolish. So if you want that Krishna should be foolish, then he is not going to follow you, because he doesn't want to be foolish. He comes to establish dharma and he comes to remove the adharmic people. Paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha duskritam. So how to do vinash, how to destroy the duskritis, that's what he is doing. Now he remains, I'm truthful. The thief comes to you and says, where is your money? Oh, it is there. So he takes happily and goes away. And somebody asks, why did you tell him? Well, I cannot tell lies.
So you're saying that lies can be said in a particular situation?
Of course. That's exactly what I'm saying. The principle is not truth or lie, principle is satyam. In yoga marg, they are saying ahimsa. But ahimsa is also not the ultimate principle. So what does Bhagavatam say? Dharma prajjita kaitu vatra parmo nirmat saranam saram satam. So all these other dharmas, Krishna himself says, sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam vraja. That is the param dharma. So what you are speaking is the normal dharma. Even in normal dharma, there is dharma and there is apad dharma. So you might have heard the story in the Upanishad, it comes, I think it comes in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, that this sage was going and this one Nishad, he is eating some udad dal, mash actually, not udad, some sprouted beans, you know. So he says, give me some. So he says, but I am already eating it and it's, you know, touched by me. So no, give me. But generally you don't give food which is on your plate and you are already eating from that. So he says, no, give me. So he takes and he eats and then he gives him some water. He says, no, water I don't take. He says, why? He says, if I take water then I'll fall down from my dharma. So he says, this is very strange.
You
had the sprout from my plate which were uchchishta. And water I am giving, you say that you'll, so you don't fall down. He says, no, because water is available and I can drink. But food was not available and I am starving for last 20 days or something. And if I don't eat, I will die. So I have to protect my body. So this is apad dharma. He says, but I will not take water. So there is dharma and there is apad dharma. So when apad dharma is there, then this normal dharma is given up. So you should not sit on the same level as Guru, right? Should not sit next to him. But if you have to go in a boat together, or you are flying in a plane, and you have seat next to him, then what do? You sit same level. So it is allowed, because dharma is not some fanatical thing. Dharma is also practical, because dharma dharayate praja. Dharna dharmiti ahu dharma dharayate praja. Dharma is that which upholds society, which upholds you, not that it kills you. Dharma is not there to trouble you. So if you make this rule, then you will not be able to fly with your guru. You cannot sit in the same boat or bus or somewhere in the car. So then you will follow dharma, but you will become so impractical. Right? So you should not cross the shadow of your guru, but in such situations you cannot avoid. So therefore dharma has to be understood, that why the principle, there is a reason why the principles are made. But then you also, if you understand that, then you can say that in such circumstances you can tell lies. So Chanakya says if the marriage vivahe, he gives 4 or 5 situations. Narishu something, there are 5 things you can tell lies. Of course that is another niti. But he is also speaking from practical point of view. So intention is not to cheat others and deprive them of their rights. But just as cheating others is adharmic, allowing yourself to be cheated is equally adharmic. Because you are also a human being. So if cheating others is adharmic, then allowing yourself to be cheated is also adharmic. So that's what Krishna is teaching. So people, they follow rules, and then that's why Balaram became angry. But Krishna is not Balaram. Krishna is Krishna. He didn't want him. He did not want Balaram to be around, because Balaram is straightforward. Right?
Subhadra's pastime, where Subhadra gets married, then he acts so innocent that he doesn't know anything, but he's only called Arjuna and got him married to, like, Subhadra was loved by Arjuna and taken away, and then when Balaram asks him, he acts as he doesn't know anything, so...
No, he didn't say that, he did not know anything. When Balaram came and told him that, what, do you know that Arjuna has kidnapped? And he said, yeah, really? So he asked him, so you don't want that? He said, it's good, don't you want your sister to be married? And he said, yes. So she found a husband, and who is more qualified than Arjuna? So Balaram had no answer. So acting as if he does not know, this is not a lie. Have to see the situation and act. Otherwise you are just Bholenath. So that is also impractical. You have to see the intention. It's not just what you say, what is your intention. Sometimes people speak truthful words, but the intention is wrong.
Bhavati Maharaj, like in this normal, in today's world, in the judiciary, because I was in one of these court martials, so then it was cited that to undo one wrong, you cannot do another wrong. So they said, this is the principle, if some wrong has been done to you, then it is the job of the judiciary to decide by you taking law in your hand. So now in this case, do we understand that when this Satyavratam is said, that at that time Krishna is like judiciary?
Well, judiciary, you are talking about some now management. At present you have a different law, so they are speaking according to that law. So you cannot apply that now 5000 years ago. Law is changing society, how it manages itself. So now you have made a law and the lawmakers have thought that it is the right thing. But it may not be right. The laws also have flaws. They are made by human beings. Therefore, they have to make amendments. So somebody is coming to kill you. So now what should you do? You are going to run to the police at that time, or you protect yourself? So can law at that time say, well, you should not do another wrong when another is doing wrong? Can you say that? So it is not applicable everywhere. I also have a right to defend myself. It's not that for every small thing I'm going to run to the judiciary or I'm going to run to the police. Even they would not like that. Somebody is attacking me, can I just say, well, now he is making a wrong act, so I should not punch him back or I should not shoot at him because one wrong should not be countered with another. No, it's not wrong. You have to also define what is wrong. Even law allows you to defend. So you have to think, somebody is same thing, if somebody is cheating you, then what do? Not cheat, allow yourself. Then judiciary, you run 10 years to get the judgment and spend so much money. And who is going to prove who was right? You need defendants. Even the judge cannot give a decision. Even if he sees himself something is done, he cannot give judgment unless there is a witness who says, yes, this happened. Judge alone cannot give judgment. If judge is sitting and there is another person and there is no one else and somebody comes and shoots that person in front of the judge, what judge can say? He will deny, no, I did not do it, and judge will say, I do it. No, he did it. So unless we have a witness, he cannot, his word cannot be taken for authority. Okay. So now the second verse. एकायनो असौ द्विफलस्त्रिमूल चतुर्रस पंचविध षडात्मा सप्तगष्टविटपो नवाक्षो दशच्छदि द्विखगो हियादि वृक्षः. सो दे आर प्रेइंग टू कृष्णा दैट एकायनो असौ, दैट दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड, दिस इज लाइक ए ट्री, आदि वृक्ष, दिस इज द ओरिजिनल ट्री. And it has ek ayana. Ayana means shelter. So its shelter is one. That is the prakriti. Because it is all made from prakriti. From prakriti comes mahatattva and ahankara and so on. And dvifala. There are two fruits of this material world. So which are the two fruits? Sukha and dukkha, happiness and suffering. So sansara visvikshasya dvayu rasvat phale. There are two nice fruits, two good bad fruits. Two nice fruits are association of sadhus and shastra ras. And bad ones are these material misery and material happiness. Three mula, and it has three roots, which are sattva, rajas and tamas. And chaturasa, there are four rasas in the form of dharma, artha, kama and moksha. And panchavidha, so five types of five branches in the sense of five areas. So sense of seeing, hearing, touch, taste and smell. And shadatma, then there are six further atma, you can say, as its parts, so which are distress, delusion, old age, death, hunger and thirst, or everything comes into, takes birth stage for some time, increases, transforms, diminishes and dies. And saptatvak, there are seven skins of it, which are the seven elements, like in our material body. So you have the chyle, blood, meat, fat, and this majja, bones and semen. And ashtavitapa, so eight branches are described as five material elements, mind, buddhi, intelligence and ahankara. And navaksha, nine, aksha means sense, so these are the nine holes in the body. And dasha chadi, 10 leaves, so these are 10 types of air, pran, saman, vayan, udan, apan, nag, kur, mukulkar, devdatta, dhananjaya. So this, and dvikhaga, and there are two birds sitting on it, so that is atma and paramatma. So samano viksha parishasva jate. So nanu yadi dehendriya dhamadi visishto ahameva satyastarhi jagadidam kim asatyam. So Vishnath Chakravarti, to give the relationship of this verse with the previous verse, is making a question from side of Krishna. Because they said that you are Satyavratam, Satya Param, Trisatyam, you are all this Satya. So he says, so you are saying that my body, my senses, my abode, my Sankalpa, all these are Satya, they are all true. So what about this Jagat then? Does it mean that it is Asatya? Means it is not real. So then they speak this verse. Tatra jagatah satyatve api kala chedyatvam. So this universe is also satya, it is also real, but it changes with time. Krishna is real. Real means that which exists in past, present and future. When we say something is illusory, means which may be appearing now, something which is not real, false, something which seems to be now but not in the past or future. So it says that the world is also real, but it changes with the time. Krishna is unchanging reality and world is the changing reality. So then, therefore he describes this in the form of a tree. Like the tree comes from the seed, then it grows, then it dies, but then the seed comes and again grows. So tavatu tadabhavetyahu. So you are not conditioned by time, means you are not changing with time. like the world. Asau prapanchaha, the word asau here means this material world. Adi vriksho bhavati. So this world is like a tree. So as tree comes into existence, then stays for some time, it grows, it transforms, gives fruits, flowers, then it becomes old and then it dies. So like that universe also, it comes, it is created, stays for some time, expands, science also says that it is expanding, then it will start contracting, then it will be finished. So prathmatayeva pravrittatvad adhi vishyate, so it is called adi vriksha. So adi means that it is the first thing which is created before even living beings are created, the universe is created. And vriksha, it comes from the root avrishya, chedane. So vrishyate kalena chedyate iti vriksha. So vriksha means that which is cut. So people also cut trees. And even if you don't cut it, sometimes they are uprooted by the wind. Big storm comes, they fall down. Otherwise, one day they become old and they will fall down. So that's why they are called vriksha. Michu. Michu dekha? So vrishchik, which cuts, bites. So it's from the same root that you have the word vriksha. So then this vriksha or tree is in two forms, samashti, vyashti rupa. So there is a cosmic person and then there is an individual. So there are individual living beings, that is vyashti. And then this whole universe is also a purusha, person. So both are compared to tree. Urdhamula madha saka swattham prahur avayam chandansi yasya parnani yastam vedasa vedavit. So this is the urdhamula. Eka prakriti, so eka, ekayana. Eka means prakriti, mool prakriti. So prakriti means that which manifests. And ayanam ashrayo yasya sa. Ayana means ashraya. So prakriti is the ashraya of this tree. Means it is manifest from that. It's like the tree is coming from earth. Earth is the ashraya. Dve sukh dukhe phale yasya. It has two fruits of sukha and dukha, happiness and distress or suffering. Treyo guna mulani yasya. And three roots in the form of sattva, rajas and tamas. Chatvaro varna dharma ashram dharma varasa yasya. It has got four rasas. Can say the four varnas, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, four ashramas, Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyas, or four dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Pancha indriyani, so five senses, vidha gyan prakara yasya sa. So pancha vidha, vidha here means the five types of knowledge. The knowledge which we acquire can be divided into five. Knowledge of smell, seeing, sound, taste, touch. Shadurmaya, there are six waves. So those are the Atmana Sabhavayas, which are like the six natures. Sometimes Shoka, grief, moha, delusion, jara, old age, mrityu, death, hungry, fasting, pipasa, thirsty. So these are the shadow rumis. Sapt dhatva, seven dhatus. Dhatu also means that which holds dharan. So our body, it has tvak. So tvak is skin, ashring, blood, mass, meat, maida, fat, asthi, bone, vasa. This is what is marrow, shukrani, semen. They are dhatus. So he changes rasa to tvak. Generally have rasa. Rakta. Ashtau. So eight things are five elements. Prithvi, aptej, vayu, akasa, earth, water, fire, air, ether. And then mind, manas, buddhi, intellect and ahankara. And vitpa, shakha, vistara, yasya. These are the branches, because these are the ones which spread around. All the objects are made of these five elements. And those who are living being consciousness, they have got three things extra. Mind, intelligence, ahankara. They work with that. That is what brings all the variety. Right? So much variety comes because of mind, intelligence and ahankara. If mind, intelligence, ahankara is not there, what will be there? Everything will be just like dead. So more mind works, more variety comes. And then we have Navdwarani, nine gates. Aksha Chidrani, yes, Aksha here means the holes. So these are in the body. And then 10 pranas. So body functions by the 10 pranas, the various types of functions which are happening. Movements, so much movement is happening. And blood is flowing, you eat food that is getting digested, then it is spread all over the body. Different parts of our body need different types of nourishment. So that is all separated and supplied without us knowing. That brain needs something different, hands needs different, eyes need different, right? Different colors. Like your hair is coming of one color, skin has another color, teeth another color, lips another color. So how this gets separated from the same food? You eat the same pasta, but it gets distributed and so many colors are extracted from this and it goes, right, to make different parts of your body. So it's quite an arrangement which is there. So this happens with the help of the pranas. All the activities in our body, the pumping of the blood, circulating, getting the impure blood back, then taking breath, extracting oxygen from that, putting it into the blood, circulating. All this happens with the help of prana. Food you eat, it goes down, digested, thrown out. Speech is coming, seeing, opening, closing of the eyes, headache also. And it also happens when your prana gets disturbed. So all these things happen by the pranas. So these are described like the leaves. Patrani vidyante. Sradhasachadi. Yes.
Have a little input about the under what situation you can tell the lies. It is quoted in 8th canto, chapter 19, Sukracharya 6, the very last verse. Vishnu vivahecha vritti arte prana sankate go brahman arte hinsayam na anritam syat jugupsitam.
Okay, you can translate.
When you have to give your daughter for wedding, then you can tell the lies. You can tell lies.
That is it.
Wrong things in your resume or in your CV. At the time of your Pran Sankat, in difficult situation in your death, or for protecting Brahman and cows, any hinsa or non-violence is done at that time, speaking lie is not jugupsitam.
Okay, so this is the niti, sukra niti. Chanakya adds one more, says, well, joking. Sometimes joke is also necessary. So he says, well, joking.
Word, narma.
Hmm?
Narma word is also used, narma vivahecha.
Yeah, so narma is joking. Narma is specifically used for friendly relationship. So Dvau Jiveshwarau Khagau Yasmin Se. So these are the two birds, Dvau Saparna Asarja Sakhai. So they are sitting on this tree. So that is also greatness of God, that He is sitting with you and does not leave. He's keen to see what you will do. What do you want to do? Nanda said, Tvameke vasya sata prasuti, tvam sannidhanam tvamanugrahascha, tvam maya samvritascetas tvam pasyanti nanana vipaschitoye. So he says that you, one only, are the source of this universe. And you are the ultimate shelter, means the place of dissolution, sannidhanam. And you are also the maintainer, anugrahascha. But those whose minds are covered by maya, they cannot see this. However, those who are intelligent, vipaschita, they can see it. So this is a very important verse, because it's different people have different theories about creation. So in Nyaya philosophy, they say that Ishvara is there, but Ishvara is not the only person who creates. Ishvara is only the nimitta karana. He is only an instrumental cause. He is not upadan karana. In Nyaya, they do not accept God as the material cause or ingrediential cause. So according to Nyaya, there are atoms of water, earth, fire and air. And these atoms are eternal, parmanu. Atom does not really mean the atom which we have now, but subtle part of matter which cannot be further divided. And these are eternal, so at the time of dissolution, atoms are still there. And Akash is there, but Akash does not have atoms. Akash is also eternal, the ether is eternal, and the atoms of the other four elements are eternal. So when God creates, then He uses them and creates. So God is not the source of them, because God is non-material. So here that is denied, because tvam eka eva. So eva means anya yoga vyavcheda, that not anything else but you only. So this is the Vedanta philosophy, that God is abhinna nimitta upadana karana. He is both the nimitta karana and upadana karana, instrumental cause as well as the ingrediential cause. So He supplies also the ingredient from Himself, because it is His energy and not independent of Him. So this kind of Duality does not exist in Vedanta. Then Sankhya also has dualistic approach. They say there is a Purusha and there is a Prakriti. And they come together and creation happens. So Prakriti is not part of the Purusha, and not dependent on Purusha, but independent. And then we have Advaitavada, which says Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya. So they accept that there is only one, but they deny the reality of the world. So here he says, no, tvam eke eva asya sataha. Sata means real. You are the one cause, you are the only one cause of this real world. This tree which was described previously is also sata. It is not mithya. It is also real. And it is from you that it comes. So, janmadashyataha. So, janma, sthiti and laya, they all come from him. So, imani va bhutani jayante. And jatani jivanti, tampradi abhisambishanti. So they come from him, they subsist because of him, and then they enter into him. So when we say that something enters into something, means that is the also, that signifies that he is the ingredient cause. So that is the proof. Because when it is breaking down and wherever it goes, it will go back to its ingredients. So if after dissolution it is going in him, then he is the ingredient cause. Because an object is broken down, and once it breaks down, it goes back to its ingredient cause. So therefore he is both. So that is being described here. Tvam eka eva satah prasuti sattvam sannidhanam tvam anugrahasya. But if that is true, why we do not know this? So how is that we do not see this? So he says, because of maya. Ajnane navritam jnanam tena muhyanti janta. So we are covered by maya, therefore we cannot see it. But those who are not covered, they can see. Svatvat shakti karyatvat vrikshoyam tadiya eva tiyahu tvameva. Because this universe is manifestation of God's energy, therefore this tree which was described in the previous verse is also belonging to him only. Because if it is his energy, if it is a manifestation of his energy, then it belongs to him. If you utilize some of your own property to make something, then it will belong to you, because the ingredients belong to you. So the product which comes out of that will also belong to you. Not that now it will belong to someone else. So therefore he says that it is tadiya eva. It is only yours. Tvameva asya prapancha vrikshasya sataha satyasya ek eva prasuti utpadaka. So this universe or this world which is described like a tree, and this is real. Sataha means that which has astitva. anything for which you use the word asti, for which you use is, existent, that must have existence. It cannot be false, because something which is false, you cannot use is, like the horns of a rabbit. You cannot say horns of a rabbit exists, because they don't exist. They are not real. So sataha means that it has its satta, it has its existence. So as Krishna says, nāsto vidyate bhāvaha, nā bhāvo vidyate sataha. So that which is sat is not non-existent, and that which is non-existent is not real. So na asato vidyate bhava, that which is unreal does not have existence, like the horns of a rabbit. So this world therefore is sata, and he alone is the source of it. So the word prasuti means utpadaka or the creator, and sannidhanam, so nidhan means the place of rest. So layasthanam, where it gets dissolved ultimately. Anugraha palaka, anugraha means the maintainer, one who nourishes it. Bhava pradhan nirdeshena tattad adhikyam abhipraitam. So by using the word this sannidhan, anugraha, prasuti, these are in bhava pratyaya, so it shows their excessiveness. Means ultimately that it is the real. Nanu bhavadadyo brahma vishnu rudra evam bhuta prasiddha katham ahamiti chet. So now Krishna is raising a question that you all are also there. Brahma is creating, Rudra is there. So why you say I am the only one? So then he says that those who think like this, they are covered by Maya. Tatrahutvan mayaya asamvrita chetasaha anavrita jnana tvam nana na pashyanti yevipashyata. So there are two ways you can break this sandhi here. Tvan maya asamvrita cheta, or you can say tvan maya samvrita cheta. So if you break it, tvan maya asamvrita cheta, those whose minds are covered by Maya, then you have to say that te na pashyanti, nana pashyanti, they see things here as in variety, but not those who are intelligent. Ye vipashyata te tu na pashyanti, they see only you, vasudeva sarvamiti. Or if you want to break it, tvan maya asamvrita chetasa, those whose minds are not covered by your maya, so they are intelligent, and they don't see the variety. Sarvam khalu idam brahma. So martyo mirtu mapnoti yai hevu nana eva pashyati. One who sees here variety, then he goes from death to death. Because that means he is not realizing one underlying truth or reality beneath it. So tvam nana na pashyanti evi pashyata. So they do not see this variety, they are intelligent. Te brahmadi nam tvav avataratvatiti bhava. So they understand that Brahma etc. are only your avatar. They are only manifestation of you and not independent. Vibharsi rupani avabodhayatma kshemaya lokasya characharasya sattopapannani sukhavahani satam bhadrani muhukhalanam. So you are avabodhatma, means your form, your body is not material, it is pure consciousness. and you manifest various forms for the welfare of the world, which contains movable and immovable beings. Sattvopannani sukhavahani satam abhadrani mukhalanam. So those who are sata, those who are devotees or satpurushas or sadhus, for them you manifest various forms which are sattva, made of vishuddha sattva. And they bring happiness to saintly people. And muhukhalanam abhadrani. And they bring suffering for the evil people, khalas. So like we see how Kansa, he is terrified. Everybody is feeling happy, all these devas are happy, they are praying to Krishna. But Kamsa is, he cannot sleep, he has lost his sleep. He is eating, he is walking, he is sleeping, he is talking, he is only full of fear. So Krishna Maya Jagat. So that is what happens to Khala. Those who do not accept God, they are always in fear. Because all the time things are changing. Fear means this feeling that you are going to lose something in future. Fear is about future. Right? Something is going to happen. It has not happened yet. So you become full of fear because of that. So COVID has not yet come. But fear is there, it can come. So like that, the khalas, the evil people, they are always full of fear. Because they want to hold on to the body and their possessions and relatives and enjoy. But even if no one else is troubling them, time is taking it away. Time is stealing whatever you have. Time is a big thief. And then otherwise also there is a fear that somebody can take. But satam sukhavahani. But the saintly people, they don't think like that, because for them everything is belonging to God. So anyapi matsya kurmadayo bahava stvadavatara santityahu vivarshiti. So not only that, this is this particular form of Krishna, but there are many other avatars. Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Nrsingha, Vamana. And they are all avbodhatma, they are all chidghana, they are all transcendental, pure conscious. Sattva uppannani, shuddha sattva sarupani. So all these forms are shuddha sattva. So sattvam shuddham vasudev sabditam. Yatra pumani yate apavritam. So that's where he manifests himself. And khala nam abhadra karani. So evil people, they are afraid because they think, although nothing abhadra, nothing really happens, even the evil people, they do not get anything inauspicious. If they are killed by an avatara, but they think like that. Because of that tanu maninar, considering themselves as body or giving respect to the body, and they lose it, so then they become fearful. So we'll stop here if there is any question.
Babaji, like in the previous sloka, it was saying that one sees one underlying reality. So, like, but in Vyavahar, we see the variety, na? Because in Vyavahar, if you see one reality, then you will not be able to do any Vyavahar with anyone.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, underlying reality, not overlying. variety within one. So variety is there, but the root is one. Just like he said that the root or ekayana, the shelter, is one prakriti. So it is all coming. So in the same way, the ultimate shelter is Krishna. Aham sarvasva prabhava matta sarvam pravartate. Can give the mic there.
You mentioned all these ten different prana. That they are regulating all the function of the body. So the motion and the movement is behind it. From where they get the energy to.
The prana itself is the energy.
It has itself.
Yeah. It's like the wind is blowing. From where does it get the energy?
Inside.
So some pressure goes low somewhere and then it comes. So like that. Changes happen in the body.
They don't
energize. Well, energy is there. You are getting. You have to eat food.
They also food.
Yeah. Okay.
Babaji, one more last question. Like today is Janmashtami, so all these devas are praying when Krishna is going to appear. So normally, the best way to celebrate Janmashtami is to listen to these prayers or do kirtan, etc.
Yeah, do kirtan, listen to prayer, read Bhagavatam, whatever. Remember Krishna's name, his activities, sing, do japa, kirtan. That's the way to celebrate.
Abhijit Pranabs, I have a small question.
Yes.
The one of the fruits is moksha. But the root is sattva, rajas, and tamas. Moksha requires bhakti as well in order to actually create moksha. Sattva guna is not sufficient. So how do we understand this here?
So now if you have bhakti, you need body or not?
Yes.
So that's what he's saying.
Okay.
If body is not there, then where will bhakti manifest? Moksha is Baddha Mukta Iti Vyakhya Gunta Mena Vastata. So, bondage, liberation, this is not Vastuta, it is only Maya Mulatvat. Name Moksha Na Bandhana. But it has to happen in the body. So if you have tree and it gives fruit, don't you have to give some water also? Yes. If you don't give water to the tree, can it give fruit? So all the water is given to the tree, still you say that the fruit is belonging to the tree. You don't say the fruit is coming from the water. So bhakti is like water. And the tree is there.